Hi guys. The following footage is clips of me replacing the forks in the Claude Butler. It was going to be part of another video, but that all got messed up. But I kept the footage, and I decided to make a separate video with it. So, if it looks a bit odd or sounds a bit odd or out of place, that's why. So, I hope you enjoy. Okay, I decided while I'm waiting for that guy to turn up, I might as well make a start on this. So, there seems to be a lot of play in here. I thought it was in here, but it's not. There's a lot of play in here. There's a smidge, tiny bit in here that's not worth worrying about, but most of it seems to be in here. So these forks are a bit worn, so I don't remember where I just put the hexagon key. Prefer to use these long ones. First thing I will do is drop the wheel out of the way, so I'll just pop one there for a moment. Quick release, like the wheels I want to pop in there. Well, I say quick release, I do them up rather tight, as you can see. Need some extra leverage. I do that for a reason, though. Prevents people trying to steal your wheels. But they are handy if you like load your bike into a car or something to travel, to do some trail riding or something. You know, you don't want to be pissing around with bolts, do you? It's just easy to whip the things off. Oh crap, I've got that. I was hoping I didn't have to, but I've got to. I'm going to take the bloody brake cable off. I'm going to take the caliper off anyway, because I want to throw it on the floor. In theory, I should have this mostly done before it gets here anyway. I've got it set up in my... This is the only time I use my stand, because it makes life easier for doing these sorts of jobs. I can do it just as quick otherwise. I haven't got to cut the cable. That is brilliant. All I've got to do is just unbolt it and slide it through the slot there. A convenient slot in the end there. I'll just pull the cable up and through the stop. Like that. Now, I believe I'm ready to get these handlebars off. It's a pity I couldn't angle you up, but what I'm going to do is just undo those. They're sixes, aren't they? Yep. I don't know, the top one should be a five. What is that? A six? No, that is a five. I'm just going to loosen these off. Flame of hell. Oh! I did those tight. Jesus! It's no wonder my bikes don't fall apart. You've got to get them undone first. Just hold the handlebars. Well, that top one wasn't as tight. Let's see what. Oh, it looks like I could have, looks like I could have actually let's see on here. I've raised the handlebars a bit more. Not by much though, but I could have if I wanted to. Should just be able to reuse the bearings that are already in here. They're not too warm. No. The problem is with this stand design, the implant does rotate. Which isn't actually a bad thing in a sense. It's only a bad thing when it decides to rotate when you don't want it to rotate. Because it's only got that tube and that clamp there that clamps it, so even when you put that down as tight as you can, even with the weight in there, it still rotates, which is annoying. It rotates in all sorts of directions. Anyway, theoretically now I should be able to drop these old forks out. I'll get the new forks in before I got no weight on the front now, so it's all tilting. Lower bearings are fine. Can I I can reuse the lower bearings. I've just got the mudguard and reflector to take off those, but for a second there, I didn't think I was going to be able to. Put the fucking bearings on first. Right, stick that up there. Got to try, I hope. Maybe if I can hold the back end. Yes, the top bearings are fine. I just need to get some weight in there. It's not that nice, of course not. Right. Just like that on, that on, that on. What am I going to give you there? Oh shit, that's what I was going to do. Try and find a dust cover for the top there. What I might do is, it's going to be sitting at an angle, I'm just going to drop the stand a bit as well. I won't be able to get the front reflector on as normal. This is glorious. I might as well clean the bloody thing while that's up there, it needs a clean. Oh good, and I did put a free wheel on the wheels. I might actually leave the wheels in, I don't know. Although that front one squeaks in the disc. My box of tricks that I've got here. I don't think that works actually making any difference. I want a seal, is what I'm looking for. Because I didn't have one at the time. But that's completely. Yep. I don't think that's going to work. So I need a rubber seal to go around this little bit here. Get the cat hair off. Come think of it, I will need some more spacers. Black ones preferably. Mainly because I don't think I'll have enough of the others. I don't think... No, that's not going to be nowhere near big enough. If I haven't got one, then there ain't nothing I can do about it. I just want to tidy it up more than anything. I could try this one. I'll put that there. I'll give it a try. If it don't work, I'll just take it off again. Go back to as before. Got plenty of black spaces from the look of it, that's alright. No, I don't need that. Well, I actually thought I had the, a spare seal. Oh well, doesn't matter. Okay, so what was I going to do? I was going to try that one first, wasn't I? So, in... Whoops. Oh, I might need a shitload of black spice. Oh, I know. Hopefully they'll just stay there for a second. Don't move, please. I'm used to some sort of stinky grease on this as well. I'll clean that off with a rag. Front brake squeaking. It appears not. It appears to be the roof. Okay, the roof. I don't want to move just yet. No. You need at least two of the shallower ones, or another big one. Diameter though, so that looks weird. That on there. Right. So now I want the bolt. Where did I put the bolt? There I put the bolt.
I do apologise for you not being able to see. I'll show you what I've done in just a moment.
Being two different sizes. Crank down one of these just enough so it grips. I don't know if that's going to be loose enough yet. Nah, I think I'll just go back to the old way. I think that's the best option. Because at least I know that way works. Swap hexagon keys again. Which I could put you a little higher. I haven't got anything to lean you on, otherwise I'd do that. I'm sat the bug. That's a little bit better, isn't it? A weird angle. A weird angle's better than no angle. Right. What do I do with that? I've lost me bearing cone for this. Where did it go? For that? No, oh, that's a spacer. There's spacers. That's a plastic bit that I don't want. Oh, bugger me sideways. It was on here. I didn't even see the grease mark where it was. Wipe that off before it dry. Is that that? No, I might just have to move here a minute to see if I've done a dopey thing and dropped it in here. Because I might have. Did I? I've got another. Well, that one, but that's not the right one. for, but I can't find the bloody thing. It's not over there, not over there. It was there. Done with it. Knocked it down here, have I? Nope. Well, what the hell? But the damn thing is right in front of me and I can't see it. Definitely, I'm in here. Nope. Got sealed bearing, but I don't think I'd fit in that somehow. Should have a pair of those in here. Okay, I decided while I'm waiting for that guy to turn up, I might as well make a start on this. So, there seems to be a lot of play in here. I thought it was in here, but it's not. There's a lot of play in here. There's a smidge, tiny bit in here that's not worth worrying about, but most of it seems to be in here. So these forks are a bit worn, so I don't remember where I just put the hexagon key. Prefer to use these long ones. The first thing I will do is drop the wheel out at the one, so I'll just pop one there for a moment. Quick release, like the wheels I want to pop in there. Well, I say quick release, I do them up rather tight as you can see. I think that adds some extra leverage. I do that for a reason though. Prevents people trying to steal your wheels. But they are handy if you like load your bike into a car or something to travel, to do some trail riding or something. You don't want to be pissing around with bolts, do you? It's just easy to whip the things off. Oh crap, I was hoping I didn't have to, but I've got to. I'm going to take the leg brake cable off. I'm going to take the caliper off anyway, because I want to throw it on the floor. In theory, I should have this mostly done before it gets here anyway. I've got it set up in my... This is the only time I use my stand, because it makes life easier for doing these sorts of jobs. I can do it just as quick, otherwise. I haven't got to cut the cable. That is brilliant. All I've got to do is just unbolt it and slide it through the slot there. A convenient slot in the end there. I'll just pull the cable up and through the stop. Like that. Now, I believe I'm ready to get these handlebars off. It's a pity I couldn't angle you up, but what I'm going to do is just undo those. They're sixes, aren't they? Yep. I don't know. The top one should be a five. What is that? No, that is a five. I'm just going to loosen these off.
Flaming hell.
Oh! I did those tight. Jesus! So no wonder my bikes don't fall apart. You've got to get them undone first. Just hold the handlebars. Now that top one wasn't as tight. Let's see what. Oh, it looks like I could have, looks like I could have actually, raised the handlebars a bit more. Not by much though, but I could have if I wanted to. I should just be able to reuse the bearings that are already in here. They're not too warm. The problem is with this stand design, the implant does rotate. Which isn't actually a bad thing in a sense. It's only a bad thing when it decides to rotate when you don't want it to rotate. Because it's only got that tube and that clamp there that clamps it. So even when you put that down as tight as you can, even with the weight in there, it still rotates. Which is annoying, it rotates in all sorts of directions. Anyway, theoretically now I should be able to drop these old forks out. I'll get the new forks in before I... got no weight on the front now, so it's all tilting. Lower bearings are fine. Can I... I can reuse the lower bearings. I've just got the mudguard and reflector to take off those, but... That's right. For a second there, I didn't think I was going to be able to. Put the fucking bearings on first. Right, stick that up there. I've got to, try, I hope. Maybe if I can hold the back end. Yes, the top bearings are fine. I just need to get some weight in there. Oops, of course not. Like that on, that on, that on. What was that giving you there? Oh shit, that's what I was going to do. Try and find a dust cover for the top there. What I might do is it's going to be sitting at an angle, I'm just going to drop the stand a bit as well. I won't be able to get the front reflector on as normal. Clean the bloody thing while that's up there, it needs a clean. Oh good, and I did put a free wheel on the wheels. I might actually leave the wheels in, I don't know. Although that front one squeaks in the disc. Now, my box of tricks that I've got here. I don't know if it's actually making any difference. I want a seal, is what I'm looking for. Because I didn't have one at the time. But that's completely. Yep. I don't think that's going to work. Oh, hello. That ain't going to work. So I need a rubber seal to go around this little bit here. Get the cat hair off. Can't think of it, I will need some more spacers. ones preferably. Mainly because I don't think I'll have enough of the others. I don't think... No, that's not going to be nowhere near big enough. If I haven't got one, then there ain't nothing I can do about it. I just want to tidy it up more than anything. I could try this one. I'll put that there. I'll give it a try. If it don't work, I'll just take it off again. Go back to as before. Got plenty of black spaces from the look of it. That's all right. No, I don't need that. Well, I actually thought I had the a spare seal. Oh well, doesn't matter. Okay, so what was I going to do? I was going to try that one first, wasn't I? So, in That's a little bit better, isn't it? A weird angle. A weird angle's better than no angle. Right. What do I do with that? I've lost me, spacers. That's a plastic bit that I don't want. Well, bugger me sideways, it was on here. I can even see the grease mark where it was. Wipe that off before it dries. To move here a minute to see if I've done a dopey thing and dropped it in here, because I might have. Did I? I've got another. Well, that one, but that's not the right one. What I'm looking for, but I can't find the bloody thing. It's not over there, not over there. Was there? Done with it. Knocked it down here, have I? Nope. Well, what the hell? But the damn thing is right in front of me and I can't see it. I'd fit in that somehow. Should have a pair of those in here. Yeah, there's the other one. There's a cup with a sealed bearing in it. Be back. Well, 5 minutes later I got them in. I found a better one. Still needed a thing to go around here, but I don't seem to have one. But it does cover the hole better and look better, so, and it actually fits better. I've just got to tighten these up. I've got the front wheel in, brake connected, I've just got to readjust it. So, in theory, all I've got to do is drop the back wheel out, swap the free wheel for that one, and put that wheel in. And I will give this frame a good old clean down. It needs it. Not only have I got my dirty paw prints all over it, but it's got mud all over it as well. It needs a good clean. Yeah, but that's actually gone together pretty well. There's no play that I know of in there. If there is, well, apart from that, you know, steer right, go left kind of thing. Mustn't forget to tighten that up, but I've thrown my 6mm hexagon key down somewhere, now I can't find it. Now I'm knocking Lego everywhere as well. Right, don't know where that bit went, I can't find it. Oh well, I don't need it now anyway. I'll find it. You watch. I'll be clearing up in here in a little while and I'll find it. That's what I need, like, there's like a plastic or a rubber cover like that that goes round those bits. Like a dust cover. And I have got it. Oh, that would have made it look a little bit better as well. Never mind. Ooh. Don't matter too much. At least I haven't got a slow puncture in the front anymore. The front, the old front wheel there is punctured. It's got a slow. I don't think that wheel sit. That doesn't, does it? That don't sit in there, dead centre. I wonder if I need to just put a little washer in there to space it. I'll do that upside down. That's easier than trying to piss ass around doing it in the stand. I took the lights off to get them out of the way so they wouldn't get knocked. Where are the lights? The Lidl's light. That is actually pretty bright. Needs new batteries again, but it is pretty bright. Well, the little red LED keeps coming on indicating low battery, but it's still functioning perfectly fine. This has got the little rubber dust cover. I have to clean that table down as well. I came over this way for something, but I can't remember what it was. Oh well, couldn't have been that important then. Right. Oh, shit. Is that a 6 or a 5? I think this is actually a 6. I was looking for the silver one, but I'll line all that up with the frame. No good having a wonky handlebars. Actually, I'll do this, and I'll do it on the floor so I can line them up properly. But I'll just do this up enough for now. I'm impressed with this bike. I've had this bike in use for about 8 months. A bit of, see, it's causing a bit of rub as well, that wheel being off centre. A little bit of rub with that canopus, so. What I will do is get it upside down when it's off the stand and just put a little washer in here to hopefully knock the wheel over a little bit. I hope. Only needs to be like a fraction, that's all. Right. Back wheel, I suppose, and I'm going to need two hands for that. But, there's a good rotors on this. Probably better than the ones that I already had in there. Do I have to do anything with the rear? Nope, just undo the nuts. Right. I'm going to shut the camera off for that, because I need two hands, so. Back. Well, it's done. Put my lights back on. I haven't put the blue ones back on yet. I don't really need them on, so I'll probably leave them off. Wheels are on. I had to make a slight adjustment to the, fiddle around with the front wheel to get the spacing correct for the front disc to rotate smoothly without rubbing. That's working and set up. Rear brake's working and set up. I had to adjust the brake pad a smidge. And obviously, as the position of the freewheel had changed slightly, I did have to adjust the gears. But it's working. I actually think it looks better with black forks in, to be honest. Those ones, I think, are pretty much knackered. There's a lot of play in here. Because when I hit the front brake when they were in the bike, they would rock like this, back and forth. And they're rather soft, I mean. Or not. It's taken me a maybe I bet if I put a handlebar on there and push down, they'd be rather soft. Those ones are alright. That one's got a longer steer tube as well, so I've got higher handlebars now. Which is one of the reasons I wanted to put these black ones in there. Got the wheels in from the other bike. I'll probably keep these ones as a spare, and I'll find another pair for the giant frame. Or even if it's just a front brake, you know, I don't mind putting just the one brake on a single speed. Front or rear, whatever I can do. Well, I can't do a rear one because I haven't got a rear disc wheel. I've got a front one that I need to straighten. But, yeah, we'll do that later. Or another day. Give the frame a clean, the rims need a clean because they're a bit filthy. The hubs need a clean. It's got Kondo hubs. I don't know if they're a good brand or not, but I do see that quite commonly on these modern bikes. Anyway, when I was on my travels in town today, I bought that building blocks set. I'm not going to call it Lego because it's not Lego. 99p, so I thought, I could have some fun with it, and I'll have the plans for that little van as well. Because all those parts that they've used to build the ice cream van in this set, I've got in Lego, so I could do a proper Lego-branded version. But the other thing I was going to do is do it on a larger scale as well. But, I am going to build it up, because this is Wilco blocks. I've never had Wilco blocks. I know there's a lot of Lego fans on the groups that hate them. But a lot of hardcore Lego fans do anyway. Where'd that now come from? Must have come off that. That's my rag. Raggy. I'm gonna wash my hands before I pop into town anyway. The bike came for the bloke. Oh, for Pete's sake. Not the only time I've fluffed up my words either, not today. The guy came for the bike and he took it. I got 25 quid for it. Well, £24.87, because he was a few pence short. And I couldn't change up a £10 note, so I thought, what's 10 pence? Well, a bit more than 10 pence. 12 pence? 13 pence. I don't care about 13 pence. You know, what should I care about 13 pence when I've got that pile of shrapnel there? Probably at least £1 in that lot there, no. There's £2 in there at least. There's a lot of 10p's as well. Where the hell did all those 10p's come from? But there you go, that's what British coins look like. How much time have I got left? I've got a little bit of time. I saw a post shared on Facebook by an American friend of mine, and it was a video of these two, I called them ghetto black girls. I don't know if that would be classed as racist or not. But that's just what the video titled it as. Apparently these ghetto black girls tried to buy a takeaway at McDonald's with a $50 bill. And obviously the cashier questioned it and questioned if it was genuine and whatnot, and they threw a tantrum. Quite a large one. But anyway, even over here with our £50 notes, there's a lot of shops that don't like to take them because when it comes to counterfeiting, the £50 note over here is the common target, so I don't like, usually if you get given a £50 note over here, it's a good idea to go to the bank and get it cashed up, because I know there's a lot less chance that cashiers will question like a £20 note, £10 note or a £5 note. I'll go for a ride on this now. Bit gritty when I do that, but yeah, it works. If it starts to come and start to show signs where it's got some play in that steering, then I'll just take it apart. New bearings, new grease, and you know, redo it all, it's not an issue. I have to say, for those threadless steerer tubes or headsets, they're actually, I do like them. I can actually take those apart and put them together. Probably, I was going to say quicker, but probably easier than the other type, the threaded type, because stems that go into the threaded type of steerer tube on forks, they tend to seize in if they've, you know, if it's a really old bike and it's been out in all weathers for years and years, they tend to seize in, then you can't get the fucking things out, then you end up having to get a hacksaw and just chopping it off, then dropping the forks out, then replacing all the forks. I've been there, done that. It's just as well the forks were just as knackered as the stem, and I had a spare stem. That's the whole reason I want the forks out, actually, because they were knackered, so I just chopped through the steer tube and replaced the stem and the forks. Anyway, I haven't got many minutes left on this. Don't know how. I don't recall doing that much videoing on this. Nearly 50 minutes of video. I don't recall doing that. I don't know. Maybe there's a video hidden on here that didn't get deleted earlier. Anyway, I'm actually getting hungry. Ooh, it's 6 o'clock. No wonder I'm getting hungry. So I'm going to go do that. I'm going to go to Roy's. Because it's a rule that every time I sell one of my bicycles, I'm allowed to buy a Lego set with the funds. So long as I leave myself enough to get some, you know, food with for the next few days, till next Thursday. You never know. Might sell the ladies one, or might sell the kids one. Who knows? Be great if it does. If I does. Don't know where my tongue is tonight. Be great if I do. Right, I'm going to shut the camera off. Go get something to eat, and after that I'll transfer the footage, because I'm not going to end the video yet, because I don't know what I'm going to get up to later. We could have a laugh with this Wilco Blocks and see how shit that is. You might have enough battery power in the other camera to do one for the Lego channel, but I don't think people would appreciate that. Oh, actually what I can do is do a comparison so people can tell the difference. Because that's a question I have seen come up quite a lot on the AFOLs Facebook group. Anyway, I'm hungry. I want to go to Roy's, so I'll talk to you a bit later on.